Today's lab, I will tell you about virtual local area network, and in short, we call it as VLAN. VLAN is nothing but an independent LAN network. Independent LAN network means like we are creating some local area network with different virtual LAN number. So basically, when we connect two or more independent departments, and they can't be able to share information with each other, then we are using this VLAN configuration. And logically, we are breaking our network into multiple numbers. And the main aim of this broadcast is this one, which is broadcast control, is my first and major aim. And then I need to give security to different virtual networks. The third one is we need to reduce the overall cost of network establishment. So we will see like how we are creating this virtual network. So previously what you have seen is like whenever you are using switches, this 2960, I already told you this 2960 is a layer 2 switch. Okay. So previously what you have seen is you are connecting some end devices. Like in this case, I am connecting some PCs. Okay, so these are 6 PCs which I want to connect with this switch. And let's suppose like I'm taking the IP addresses of these switch with a network of 192.168.11. Okay, so I'm taking 192.168.11.123 for these three computers. This is your site one, having IP address range from 192.168.11.123. So second one is 2 and third one we will take 3. And set 2, we will create with IP address like 192.168.12.1 to 12.3. So now you can see that like these three computers are having different IP addresses with a different network address. Network address for this set one is 192.168.11, and network address for this set two is 192.168.12. If you talk in term of practical thing, so we are making one network architecture for an organization where two departments are there. Okay, and those two departments we name it as marketing. Okay, the first one is marketing, that is our set one, and second one is our, let's suppose it is sales. Okay, so that is sales, and sales we are taking as set two. As a network engineer or as a network administrator, my responsibility is to design a network where for this instance I am connecting 3 PCs in marketing department and 3 PCs or 3 end devices in sales department, and I want to configure my system in such a way that they can't be able to communicate with each other. In a building, like there are 3 floors of 6 floors. In the 6th floor, like marketing department is there. And in the 4th floor, sales department is there. Okay. So I want to use only one switch for these 2 floors. And I want that 6th floor can't be able to communicate with 4th floor. Okay. So this type of architecture I want to design. Okay. So, and like I want to design a very secured network with a minimum cost. Minimum cost means I need to use only this single switch in this case. Okay. And the third thing is I want to like protect my channel capacity also. For protecting my channel capacity, I need to minimize that broadcast kind of thing whenever it happens. So this is my aim. So this means like I have six floors. So this first one is my marketing one, marketing department, and this second one is my sales department. Okay, so I want to configure my network in such a way so that marketing department, they can be able to communicate with each other, but they can't be able to communicate with sales department, or they can't be able to share their information with the sales department. And sales department, they can communicate with each other, but they can't be able to share their information with marketing department. Okay, so for doing this type of thing, first we will see like what will happen if you are not creating any virtual network. Okay, so first we will analyze the case where you are not creating any virtual network. So if I like for communication, I need to connect these things with the switch. So this I am connecting at port number 2, and this PC number 3 I am connecting at port fast Ethernet port number 3, PC 4 at fast Ethernet port number 4, PC 5 at fast Ethernet port number 5. This you can connect like anywhere and at any port of the switch. Okay, for convenience of understanding this practical one, I'm connecting like with a number where you can remember those things. Okay, so in this way I have created my network. Okay, so in this case, I need to give IP addresses, static IP addresses to these desktop. So my first case is PC1, where I have given 11.1, and in PC2, I'm giving .2, PC3, PC4. So now I have defined IP addresses of set 1, that is marketing department, and set 2, that is sales department. And if I do like communication between these devices, if I ping 192.168.11, this PC1 is .11.1, and I am pinging .3. Okay, so if I do ping this 192.168.11.3, here I can see I can be able to ping it successfully. My send request, echo request is 4, and I have received 4, and my loss is 0%. Okay, and in a similar way, if I ping PC2, so I can be able to ping it successfully. But if I try for that different network, that is set to 192.168.12.1, okay, I can't be able to ping that one. So, like what we are doing now is we are making one network, okay, and that network by default it is working because all the things are connected with VLAN 1. That is default LAN. Okay, so we will see what these LANs are and how we configure this thing. Okay, so you can be for this by default case where you are not configuring anything, you can be able to communicate between PC1 and PC2, PC1, PC3, means between these PC1, PC2, PC3. And you can, if you check for PC6, like if I go to PC command window of PC6, and if I do ping of 192.168.12.1, okay, the IP address for this PC6 is .12.3, and if I ping PC number 4 or one of the PC from the sales department, I can do it successfully. So I will go to the command window of this PC3, and PC3 is there with the marketing department, which is in site 1. So for pinging any other computer in that marketing department, what you will do, you will write ping, okay, and the IP addresses wherever you want to ping. So 192.168.11.1 is the IP address for PC number 1, and you are there with PC number 3. Okay, so if you ping, you can see that whatever, like, you are sending 4 echo requests and you are receiving 4 echo requests. Okay, so your loss is 0% in this case. If you do the same thing for PC number 2 also, if you ping from PC number 3 to PC number 2 and they are in the same department of marketing 1, you will get a loss of 0%, means 100% transmission is there and the link is reliable. Okay, so this thing we can check for communication of marketing and sales department also. Like, if you can ping the sales department PC, then your computer can communicate with the sales department also. Okay, so if I type the IP address of any of the computer from sales department, like one IP address is 192.168.12.1, so I can check that they can't be able to communicate with. So for naming that VLAN, you will type like, I want to name it with marketing. Okay, so the first thing what I have did is I have enabled my switch. That after enabling my switch, I have gone to configure terminal mode, and in configure terminal mode, I have written VLAN 11 for creating a virtual network with a number 11. Okay, and that 11 I have named it as a marketing virtual network. Okay, so after this, I can exit from this configuration mode, from this VLAN 11. Okay, and I can exit also from this configuration mode. So after exiting from configuration mode, like, if you check, like, is there any VLAN number 11 created with this switch or not? So I will write the same command again, and for visualizing that thing, the command is show VLAN brief. Okay. So if you type show VLAN brief, you can see that you have created one VLAN which is 11 and having the name marketing, and that is in active mode. But with this VLAN 11, there is no port which is associated with it. All the ports are associated with VLAN number 1. Okay, so what I need to do, I need to assign some ports to this marketing department also. But before assigning those ports to marketing department, what I will do, I will create one more VLAN which is for sales department. So for creating one more VLAN, the same process I will repeat. Like, first I will enable my switch, and I will, after enable my switch, I will write configure terminal and go to configuration terminal mode, and then I will write VLAN. Suppose I want to create 12. Okay, and this VLAN 12, I am naming it as sales. Okay, so I have created one more virtual network, that is sales department. So I can visualize this thing with so VLAN brief. So now I have two virtual networks, one is 11, another one is 12, having the name of marketing and sales department. Okay, now my task is to connect to include these ports like according to our need to this VLAN number 11 and VLAN number 12. So what I have did here is I have connected port number 1 to this marketing department, port number 2 to this marketing department, and port number 3 to this marketing number, and port number 4, 5 and 6, they are connected with sales department. Okay, so what I am doing is like this port number 1, 2, 3, I am dedicating this port to marketing department, and port number 2, 3, 4, I am dedicating that port to sales department. For doing this thing, again I will go to CLI mode. Okay, and I will enable it. Then I will go to configure terminal mode, and then I will write interface interface fast Ethernet, and what I want to interface is I want port number 1 in VLAN number 11. So I will write 0/1. Okay, and after this, like there are two things. One is I want that port port number 1 as an access port or trunk port. So first we will see access port, then we will come go to trunk port. So access, for defining that port number 1 as an access port, I will write switch port mode access. Okay, so switch that port number 1, fast Ethernet port number 1 of that switch is now in access port mode, and now I can define that switch port as access to VLAN number 11, and then I can exit. In a similar manner, like what I am doing here is I am defining port number 1 to virtual LAN number 11. So the same thing I can do with port number 2 and port number 3 also. So again I will go to interface and I will write 2, then I will access switch port access mode, so that this port will convert into access mode, and then I will write switch port access VLAN 11. So port number 2 also I'm transferring it to VLAN number 11. Then again I will write interface fast Ethernet 03, and then I am giving access, then access to VLAN number 11, then exit. Then if I visualize, okay, so I can see that now marketing department, which is VLAN number 11, having 3 ports, okay, in an active status, which is port number 1, port number 2 and port number 3, and this is basically according to our need. This is port number 1, port number 2 and port number 3. Now I want port number 4, 5 and 6 with the sales department, and sales department is my number 12 in VLAN. Okay, VLAN number 12. So for transferring that one, again I can do the same procedure, or you can transfer all the things like with a single line also. For transferring, like again you need to go to configure terminal mode, then you need to write interfaced fast Ethernet and that port. So if you want to convert a range to, if you want to transfer a range from one VLAN to another VLAN, so you need to write range. Okay, this is one more method, and you can write like I want to convert 4 to 6. Okay, so I'm basically configuring the port number 4 to port number 6, and then you can write switch port mode access, and then you can write your VLAN number. Okay, switch port access VLAN number 12. So basically I am configuring port number 4 to 6. I'm giving it access, and I'm giving its access to virtual and number 12. So basically after this, if I do exit, and if I write show VLAN brief, so you can realize that now these three ports are there with marketing department, and this 4, 5, 6 are there with the sales department. Okay, so with this, what I have done is like I have created two virtual network. Okay, this one is a part of VLAN 11, and this one is a part of VLAN 12. So with this, what will happen is like the cost is we have reduced the cost, we have improved this security and broadcast control thing. So how we have improved is like if you do the same set of thing, like I am opening this PC1 having the IP address of 192.168.11.1, and now I am doing ping to broadcast one. Okay, broadcast echo I'm generating. So I'm doing ping 192.168.11.255 in simulation mode. If I realize, okay, so what I have did is I have generated one echo request in the form of ICMP, and this ICMP is now transferred to this switch. Previously, without creation of any virtual network, what is happening in that case is that switch is creating 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 replicas of that echo request and sending it to all the links connected to it. In this case, this switch will not send this echo request to this virtual number LAN number 12. Okay, this will send this echo request to all the PCs of the same network, like 192.168.11 only. Okay, so it will create two copies because only two things are there, which are connected with virtual number LAN number 11. Okay, so if you are broadcasting anything from sales department, that broadcast will go to sales department only. And if you are broadcasting anything from marketing department, that broadcast will go to marketing department only. Okay, in the previous case, when you are not creating any VLANs, your broadcast will flood over the network, over the entire network, whichever is connected under this switch. Okay, so this is happening if you broadcast from marketing department. Let's check this the same thing, broadcast kind of thing from PC6. So I go to this PC6 and then I ping 192.168.12.255. Okay, in simulation mode for analysis, I will do in simulation mode. So this PC6 is generating one ICMP. If I check it, that ICMP will go to that switch, and switch will now like they broadcast this ICMP to virtual LAN number 12 only. Okay, it will not deal with virtual number LAN number 11. Okay, so in this way, what happened is we have improved the security of our network. Okay, and we have controlled the broadcast one. This broadcast control is very important when like your network will be will have a higher number of end devices. At present, we are considering three PCs or three end devices. So this is like very small network, but when your network is very large with a switch, like you have connected few wireless routers, and with those wireless routers, like there are 50-50 computers or 50-50 mobile phones, they are connected with that one. So in that case, like your network is like very huge, and if you are not controlling your broadcast thing, so your link, or you can say in another way, your internet speed, whatever you want to communicate from outside that network will get decreased. Okay. So this is the thing. This is the advantage. Let's see some more commands so that like if you do some mistake with that switch, you can be able to correct that one also. So one mistake is like, suppose I want to create some virtual LAN, and by mistake I have, suppose I am doing that mistake now. Configuration, I'm going to configuration terminal, then I have created VLAN 23. Okay, and VLAN 23 I have named it as finance. Okay, and then I will exit. So now what I did is I have created one more VLAN, which is number 23, and that is finance one. Okay, so suppose by mistake I have created that finance department, and I want to delete that one. I don't want this finance department. So what I will do is, like, I can delete that one also. So for deleting it, so remember this thing, you need to go to your configure terminal mode. Whenever you are doing any addition or deletion, always you need to go to configure terminal mode, and then you just need to write a very simple command, that is no VLAN 23. Okay, so if you write this one and if you exit, and again if you check it, show VLAN brief, you can realize invalid input. Wait, go to configure terminal. Okay, write correct spelling. I have left L. Okay, no VLAN 23, and then you need to write exit, and then you can check show VLAN brief that there is no VLAN 23, there is VLAN 11, VLAN 12, and there is no VLAN 23. Previously it is there. Apart from this, like whatever we have seen for access ports, we have defined only access port. So suppose I take one more addition to this system, I take one more switch. Okay, and suppose I have two buildings. Okay, in one building marketing department is there, the same one at the sixth floor, and sales department is there on the fourth floor, and I have one more building, quality control department. Okay, so quality control and for quality check, like there is one separate building where all the machineries. Okay, visualize this thing. Okay, for quality check, there is one more building where like machineries are there, and they are checking the quality of the product, whatever is manufactured in that organization. So for that one, let's suppose I am connecting one switch. So let's suppose I am connecting 24 with 24. And I'm taking few PCs, two PCs for this quality control. And in that quality control building, I want to appoint one marketing person and one salesperson also. Suppose I want to do this kind of thing. Okay. So basically what I am doing here is I am assigning, this is my quality control and this one is my sales and this one is my marketing. So now what I am doing is, first let me connect all the things. Okay, so now what I did is I have created one more department, and which is quality check. Okay, so this is my set three. Now I have added one more set, and under this set three I'm defining some more network like 192.168.13.1 for one computer and 192.168.13.2 for another computer. And I have added I have created one that building actually. So this one is a separate building and this one is a separate building. Okay, these two buildings are separate one. And now after in this second building I want to allocate one marketing department PC, and I'm giving IP address like 192.168.11.4 to this second building PC of marketing department. And I'm allocating one more PC to this sales department also, which is 192.168.12.4. Okay, so now I will configure this in these PCs. So like I will go to this quality check department and configure it as 192.168.13.1. The second I will configure it as 13.2, this sales department PC I will configure with sales 192.168.12.4, and marketing department PC I will configure with 192.168.11.4. Okay, so after giving these IP addresses to these computers, we will do the same thing. Like, we will create one VLAN, one more VLAN for this quality check. Okay, so let's say we are creating VLAN number 13 for this quality check, and already they are there with VLAN number, so I'm not creating one more VLAN. So this one I am defining as VLAN 12, and this is this one is already there with VLAN number 11. Okay, so now I want to configure my switch so that it can be able to realize that whatever I want to do, or like the same thing I need to give as an instruction to this switch. Okay, so I will go to this switch. First I will enable it. Okay, if you type a command that is so VLAN brief, okay, you can check that by default all the things with the VLAN number 1, and there is no VLAN number 13 or 12 or 11. Okay, so what I will do, I will first create these three VLANs. So I will go to configure terminal mode, then I will create VLAN 11 and name it as marketing department. Okay, I will create one more VLAN, that is VLAN number 12. I will name it as sales department. I will create one more VLAN, which is VLAN number 13. I will name it as quality check. Okay, then I will exit. After this, I can check that whether whatever I have made is there with this switch or not. So we'll end brief. So quality check is there with 13, sales is there with 12, and marketing is there with 11. So I can check that there is no port associated with these VLANs. So I will associate ports with it. So I will go to configure terminal mode. After going to configure terminal mode, I will write interface fast ethernet 0/1/2/2, and this I'm doing with range, and then I am switching switch port mode SS, then switch port SS VLAN. So now, after writing all the commands, you can check that now you have quality check department where which is connected with which is like assigned for port number 1 and 2 of this switch, and sales department is assigned to port number 3 and marketing department is assigned to port number 4, and this is what we want. Okay, so now I will check like whether I can be able to communicate or not. So if I want to check, I will go to this PC number 9, and if I ping the first PC, which is 192.168.13.1 of the sales department, I can be able to ping it successfully. Okay, but if you do if you try for pinging sales department, okay, you can't. Okay, so sales department in this second building or anywhere other, that in second building that is 192.168.4, okay, that will 100% will go for 100% loss. You can like do communicate with the sales quality check department. This sales department PC, it can't be communicate to sales department in this case, because like we will see this thing also. So if I go to sales department and if I ping another sales department PC, which is 192.168.12, okay, so this request will go for 100% loss and it will be time out. But in practical case, I want that my sales department, they need to communicate with each other. In this scenario, I can't be able to communicate with sales department also. Okay, so the thing is, if I send packet from PC 8 or PC 9, it is successful. And if I send packet between this sales department and this sales department, it will go in a failure mode. Or if I send from PC 5 to PC 10 also, it will go in failure mode. And the same thing, if I realize like PC 1 to PC 11 and they are there with marketing team or marketing department, but it will also fail. And if I realize this thing with a simulation mode, like broadcasting will not happen because we have already created a virtual lens. Okay, so if I try to ping that marketing department from marketing department PC, which is 192.168.11, and suppose I am pinging PC number 2 in simulation mode. Okay, so basically the thing is, this PC number 11 is not knowing the information of PC number 1, so it will send one ARP. And that ARP will get like lost by this switch, because there is no 192.168.11 network connection with this switch. Okay, by creating this VLAN number 13, 11, and 12. So this is happening because this port. The link between this switch number 1 and switch number 2, we haven't assigned. Okay, so we need to assign that link, this link between two switch as a trunk one. Okay, so we need to define this port number 24 of this side as a trunk port, and 24 of this side as a trunk port. Okay, then only after defining that trunk port, we can be able to communicate from one switch to another switch. So we are for defining that thing, so that marketing department and devices from for this building can communicate with marketing department of this building. we need to assign trunking between these two switches. So to define trunking, so we will go to this switch number one first, and we will go into configure. First we will enable this switch, then we will go to configure terminal mode. After going to configure terminal mode, we will write interface fast ethernet, and we have connected this link, okay, between switch 1 and switch 2 at port number 24, fast ethernet port number 24 of this switch. So I will write 0/24, okay, because I need to deal with port number 24, and after like going this 24 port interface, what we will do, we will switch this port through to a trunk port. So for access port, we are writing switch port mode access. For switching from access mode to trunk mode or trunk port, we will write switch port mode trunk. Okay, then we will enter and we will exit. So you can visualize this thing also, like for whether there is any trunk port or not. So you need to write show interface trunk. So with this command, you can see that there is port number 24 and mode is on, and encapsulation is 802.1Q, and that is in the trunking mode status. This encapsulation 802.1Q, there are two types of encapsulations are there. One is 802.1Q, according to the standards of IEEE, it is taking 4 bytes for communicating between 4 bytes as a header for communicating between two switches. Another is ISL. ISL is inter switch link, and that ISL is basically developed by Cisco. So this ISL is taking more number of bytes, that is 26 bytes. So that's why by default we are using IEEE standard 802.1Q, that is taking less byte, 4 byte, for encapsulation. Okay, and we can see that the native VLAN for this port number 24 is VLAN number 1. Okay, so from VLAN virtual network 1, we are taking this port number 24, and we are converting that port number 24 from access mode to trunk mode, access port to trunk mode. So the same thing you can do for this switch, the second switch also. So you are already there in enable mode, so you need to go to configure terminal mode, and after going to configure terminal mode, you need to write interface fast ethernet 0/24, and then you need to switch port mode trunk. Okay, so in this case also you have converted a port number 24 into a trunk port. Okay, so now this port number 24 this side, port number 24 this side, they are a trunk mode. So now you can be able to communicate marketing department with the marketing department of other building, sales department with the sales department of other building, and if you can create one more PC as a quality check or another thing which belong to the same department, you can do in this. Okay, so now you can check this thing by doing ping. Okay, so previously if I do ping 192.168.11.2, that is like timed out and 100% loss is there. Now if I do the same thing again, okay, so now I can see that I can be able to communicate with a 0% loss. Okay, and if you realize in this way also, like if you want to send from PC11 to PC3, it is successful. And if you want to send PC5 to PC10, it is also successful. If you want to send from these two departments, it is also successful. But if you try like from sales department, if you communicate with marketing department, it will fail. Here also from sales department to marketing department, it will fail. If you go for quality to marketing, it will fail. Okay, so basically you are creating three sequoid sub local local area network. Okay, virtual, we are calling it as a virtual because we are using that switch, and under that switch only we are creating three types of network. Okay, with the three different network addresses. So in the first case, in my network address is 192.168.11. Second case 192.168.12. Third case 192.168.13. Okay, so this is like full explanation of virtual local area network. If you want to design some network for a different department, and you if you want to give security so that they can't be able to share information with each other, the departments. And if you want to reduce cost, you need not to go for a router. You can do the same thing with the help of switch also. And in this way, you can control broadcast also. If suppose a quality check department is generating some broadcast message, that broadcast will go into the quality check end PCs only or end devices only. Okay. And if like the sales department, okay, I will check for this PC. If I write, this is a sales department. So if I write ping 192.168.12.255 and go into simulation mode. So this is generating one ICMP packet, one echo request, and this echo request will go here. To this switch, and since there is one sales department computer in this building also, so that echo request will go to this switch, and this switch will forward to a proper link, this VLAN 12 one. Okay, and this is what happening due to this broadcast control. Okay, so if you are sending some broadcast sort of thing in one department, that broadcast will go into that department only. So I hope now virtual LAN configuration is clear with you.